this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood, I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I whistled for a cab, and when it came near, the license plate said fresh and it had dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, nah, forget it, yo, home's the Bel Air. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8, and I yelled to the cabbie, "Yo, home, smell you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel-Air.
I'm Dee Dee, and you're watching PHS News.
Isn't that my line?
Hi, guys. I'm here with Pearsall ISD Superintendent Dr. Rodriguez. And so we wanted to ask you a few questions. So as you being the superintendent, what made you decide a career in that?
So as some of y'all may know, the superintendent is kind of like the lead educational leader within each school district, right? So being that I spent many years working as a teacher, right, and coach, and becoming a campus principal, right, actually in Dilley ISD as well, right, and knowing, going through each day, going through experiences with students, right, I always wanted to make a huge impact, a bigger impact, right, moving from the classroom where I have had the impact in one classroom, and moving up to being a campus principal where I was able to impact a whole campus, and then being able to move to the superintendency level, right, which I'm able to have a huge impact in the whole district itself, which is very meaningful. So that's basically why I considered a career in superintendency, right, is to make a huge impact in that whole entire district with the support of 7 school board members as well.
Okay, and considering that Pearsall is your hometown, why do you feel it was important for you to come back and do superintendency here?
Sure. So what a way, y'all, to give back to our community, right? To give back to the community. You know, I've spent some years working as an educator, a teacher, right? And I always wanted to make an impact. I always wanted to give back to our students, right? And coming back to Pearsall ISD, right? Which really, I didn't anticipate doing that, right? It just, things happened, you know. Things happened, and the right things have happened for me, and then I was able to come back and to give back to our students as much as I could to try to provide the resources, right, the support, right, with teachers and staff so that we could make a huge, huge impact in the lives of our students over the years.
Okay, and as we are roaming your beautiful hallways, we are seeing once a maverick, always a maverick. So what does that quote directly mean to you?
So once a maverick, always a maverick, right? What that means is once you go through our school systems, right, once you walk the halls, as y'all did, right, and once you become that maverick, right, our mascot, once you go through PHS, then you'll always be a maverick at heart, right? You'll always be a part of our family. So we welcome y'all, right, to PHS, right, and to Maverick Country. So now you are considered a maverick as well, all right, by heart.
All right, and last but not least, since you have been here for a while, what is your best memory you have here?
So really the best memory itself is graduation night. Graduation night every year is unique and meaningful, right? And then we get to participate, right, in this very important ceremony, which we have an accumulation of 13 years where students go through our school systems and they finally reach the highest level, right, and that is receiving a high school diploma. and then encouraging them on to continue on their education and to continue to go on to higher education, right? So that they can also either become teachers, they can go into the CTE, the, you know, career industries, right? And they can also make a huge impact in wherever they go as well. So my best memorable memory is graduation night.
All right, and thank you, sir, and thank you for your time and allowing us to be here.
No problem.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you all.
Hi, guys. I'm here with state qualifier Zane Liao. And, sir, how does it feel to qualify 3 years in a row for your school, and how do you feel it's representing you and your community?
Yeah, I would have to say it means a lot to me, and also having to show the younger generation what it is like to come out here and compete at the state level.
Seeing as you are a great runner, are you considering running at a collegiate level?
Yes, I do. I've been thinking about some colleges, and I'm still in the decision on what I want to attend right now, but yes, I do plan on running at the college level.
Okay, and seeing you spent your past 4 years here at Pearsall High School, what is your best memory you have here?
I would have to say spending all the time with all my friends and having some great time with all the teachers, also getting to meet a lot of people and stuff like that.
All right, well, thank you for your time, Zane, and thank you for having
me. All right, thank you.
I'm here with Coach Hernandez from PHS. What aspects do you take from your high school sports career that you now apply as a coach?
I think the aspect that I take most from my high school career is probably hard work. My coaches and mentors and stuff instilled that in me, so I like to instill that in my student athletes as well.
Okay, and what is your most memorable moment as a coach?
Most memorable moment was probably whenever I got to start my first day here at Pearsall. Coming back home was a pretty big deal for me, and being able to be with those athletes and stuff. But I think a special moment was whenever we won district in 2017, game-winning field goal. That was a pretty cool one.
Okay, well, thank you for letting me interview you today.
All right, thank you.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Sienna. I'm here with the PHS Girls Coordinator. Why is it important for the community to be involved in sports?
Overall, it's important for the community to show their support for these young athletes, boys and girls, that are competing in our programs. It's important because it lets the kids know, our athletes know, that the community is behind them. It's always a positive and an impactful feeling when you're at games and the crowd is in the stands cheering for our kids and displaying a positive atmosphere. So I think it's important overall, because sometimes, as you know, in sports, it's not always, you know, a great season or an awesome season. However, we like to recognize kids and show support because they are out there on the court, on the field, on the track, competing.
And through all the years of your coaching, what is the best memory you've had?
I've been coaching a very long time, and there's a lot of great memories, especially here at Pearsall High School. I've been here for 10 years. Our best memories, I think I have to say, is whenever we have our overall program together at the end of the year when we're competing and we're participating in our annual boot camp, because everybody gets excited and everybody shows support for everybody. And just the overall positive environment that our athletes know what it takes to be committed, dedicated, and show a lot of fortitude and grit as far as competing in athletics.
Okay, well, thank you for letting me interview you today.
You bet. Thank y'all.
Hi, I'm Lily here with PHS drum major Brooke. How did the band prepare to compete at the level they're at?
So at the beginning of summer, week after week, we had been having multiple practices, whether it be early in the morning or late in the evening. We had been working really hard, and our main focus was repetition after repetition, just to make sure that we try to perfect our show towards being the best that it can possibly be.
And what advice do you have for any future drum majors?
Just don't be shy. Be a great leader, be open to any suggestions. Whenever any students are like in need of advice, go up there and help them.
And what's your favorite memory at PHS?
My favorite memory would have to be both years that we went to area, in 2018 and in 2021. It was really fun. We were all such like a tight-knit group. And then also, this is not band related, but I dressed up as Bob Ross this year for homecoming week, and I actually got an award for being best dressed. So, yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
I'm here with Ms. Vasquez at PHS. What's something interesting you've done in your classroom this year?
Okay, so I teach English too, and so something that I've done recently with my class, actually the first 6 weeks, we read a book of their choice, whatever they wanted to read, and it was like a project, and so something that they put together that you guys can see on their wall is just their thoughts on the book, their reflection and what they learned, and yeah, how it connects to the world. So it was really nice.
Okay. And how does it feel to be teaching at your alma mater?
It feels amazing. I have a special place in my heart for Pearsall High School. I grew up here my whole life, so I'd like to tell my kids that I was just like them. I know all their tricks that they try to do because I tried probably the same thing. But it just gives me great joy to be here and to give back to my community.
And what's your most memorable moment here at PHS?
So, phew. Recently, we had our little pep rally, blackout pep rally, and I was asked to do musical chairs, and one of my kids, or I guess some kids were fighting over a chair, and I almost got hit, so that was really memorable. But my most memorable moment, I would say, is actually meeting my husband, Oscar Vasquez, who's actually one of y'all's techs. I met him here in algebra class, so it's very special to me.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
I'm here with Ms. Longoria, the culinary class teacher. Why do you feel that a culinary class is important?
I feel that culinary is very important because once you're out of high school, you're pretty much on your own. So it's good to have those basic skills. If you just have staples in your household, like, flour, sugar, salt, you know, put some biscuits together, something. And considering the pandemic we were in last year, and we actually still are, a lot of students were left home with their siblings, having to cook for them and clean for them. So it's pretty vital to, you know how to cook an egg, know how to cook meat, and so forth.
What is the most interesting that you've cooked so far this year?
This year, the most interesting thing we've cooked is Halloween cupcakes. So I had some students make glass out of sugar. They were trying different recipes, and it was just a really neat and fun process.
Well, that sounds like a great time. But thank you for letting me interview you.
Thank you.